It's April 2023, a few weeks after the annual Congress of the European Association of Urology, and this means fresh guidelines for this year. As you might know, I have been treating erectile dysfunction with shockwaves for over 6 years now. If you are new to UroChannel, check out the playlist of videos about this novel type of treatment. My name is Stefan Buntrock. I'm a urologist and sexologist. While scientists are still debating over trials and the FDA still has not approved low-intensity shockwave therapy for ED, I have the practical experience from hundreds of patients with my machine and my treatment protocol. In this video, I am going to honestly refer to you my results, and we are also having a look at what the current EAU guidelines have to say. What are shockwaves, or ESWT as it is also called? They are a form of acoustic wave which exert pushing and pulling forces upon the treated tissue in milliseconds. This subsequently leads to a number of repair mechanisms. When used on the penis, ESWT will rejuvenate the tissue with a maximum effect setting in 1 to 3 months after the treatment is terminated. This means that ESWT is the only treatment modality which offers cure from erectile dysfunction. And the best part of it? It has no side effects. Sounds too good to be true? Well, there are some downsides. We'll come to that in a minute. When talking ESWT, there's a very important difference between radial and focused shockwaves. Only focused shockwaves penetrate deep into the tissue, while radial shockwaves are undirected and remain at skin level. This can be quite confusing, but only focused shockwaves have the desired effect for urologic purposes. So what do the 2023 EAU guidelines have to say? There is now a weak recommendation for patients with mild to moderate vasculogenic ED, and I quote, who do not wish or are not suitable for oral vasoactive therapy or desire a curable option. The problem is, however, that studies on ESWT differ from each other in terms of the devices and shockwaves used, energy levels, number of shockwaves per treatment, time interval between treatment sessions, and overall number of treatment sessions. And there are the different reasons and severities of erectile dysfunction. So what is my experience? I am using focused shockwaves with an electromagnetic shockwave generator. My protocol for erectile dysfunction is 2 times per week, 12 sessions in total, and a relatively high number of impulses and energy levels. I always try to combine ESWT with Tadalafil once daily to enhance the effect of the shockwaves. And there is also recent evidence from a randomized, double-blind, placebo-controlled trial which shows an increased effect of this combination after 3 months than by ESWT alone. The results I achieve vary quite a bit between patients. One should not overestimate the efficacy of shockwaves, but in mild to moderate ED, it is realistic to expect a significant improvement, which can make the difference between being able to have sexual intercourse without any further medication or not. In more severe cases, ESWT will be able to restore the efficacy of PDE5 inhibitors such as Viagra or Cialis. And of course, I have seen results at both ends of the spectrum. Some men experience massive changes, and some men don't see any effects at all. So far, I haven't figured out why this happens, and if it is possible to identify possible responders to the treatment before I even start. One thing I am sure of, however, ESWT not only works in vascular ED, but also in ED caused by pelvic floor overactivity. And the effect to be seen is more pronounced in pelvic floor overactivity. Another promising area of shockwaves for erectile dysfunction is after radical prostatectomy for prostate cancer. There is some low-level evidence suggesting that early recovery of erectile function is better if penile rehabilitation is supplemented with ESWT. I have treated a couple of patients after radical prostatectomy with mixed results. It depends very much on the age of the patient, status of nerve sparing and erectile function before surgery. My guess is that it will prove to be beneficial, but we will need more data on that within the scientific community. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.